What is up, guys? Climax Combo back with another video. I am Licious Kid.
I am Checkers.
And today we're going to go over the new Japanese ban list for Neo Standard. This will be effective June 17th. And this ban list has a lot going on for it. And I think is a healthy change for the meta. So in this video, we're just going to go over our thoughts on the ban list, why we think these cards got hit, and our overall thoughts on how this might affect the meta. We're not going to go over the cards, but we'll put everything on the screen so you can just read along if you don't know what these cards do. If we're missing any key points on why these are getting banned or whatnot, let us know in the comments below.
Also, these graphics are from Weiss Tea Time. Link in the description. Pretty cool.
Thank you, as always, for your hard work.
Woo! I mean, for the first set we'll go over, SAO, I mean, my favorite set recently. And everyone's favorite set, to be honest. This set was so strong. It was dominating like crazy. The first hit, the 1-0 Alice, is banned. Essentially, the only way you bring out the 2-1 Alice early. It was just too overpowered. Nothing could really stand up against a full board of 2-1 Alices. And how useful that card is on top of it is just so hard to beat. Very consistent to get it out. There's a lot of support cards. And they wanted to remove it because it's really not good. At level one is just too strong. So understandably it was banned. And I think with this hit, I think Alice is still really good. A similar build I could see is running Alice with Mother's Rosaria. There is a slime build that revolves around the level 2 that does this kind of same thing as Alice. She's a big body, builds up stock, and salvages or pluses you in hand size. It's just a really strong card still, so I think builds are still going to run this. But with the death of Alice, people will start trying to use the Yuna build, which was 8 gold bar Yuna, also really strong. The other bans for SAO do affect that build as well. The Leafa and the Sortiliana got added to the choice of 4, along with the Heathcliff and the level 0 Kito Pants Ditcher. With this, I think this eliminates Heathcliff being played because that Leafa is just really strong and a ton of utility. And the Sortiliana is also really strong to set up your hand, and the Yuna build kind of needs that card to even function, so you're definitely going to be running that. And so in any meta decks, there's definitely not going to be any more Heathcliff, which is good for standby. It was pretty unhealthy for standby. Not being able to encore is too nuts.
On to Overlord. They are now added to the ban list. So they have a choice of 4, but honestly, it's just a choice of 3. Those two backup cards have the same effect, just different art. So first of all, Big Daddy Ainz did get hit on the choice of 4. This card is just super cool, and we all know it's very powerful. It's just so crazy what this card can just do to the state of the game. So I think we all expected and knew it was going to get hit in some shape or form. So it is your choice, which I think is good. Along with that, we have the 1-0 Shaltier. The 1-0 Shaltier is also very powerful. Both effects are just so good. I mean, giving your characters huge boost in powers, and that second ability is what makes this card super overtuned. The fact that you can just clock yourself pretty much like during your main phase just to draw cards and to accelerate your own board and like accelerate your own game plan is just so crazy. Like, why is this kind of limited by your levels and what you can do? But this Shaltier giving you the option to just clock yourself out of nowhere at a very high payoff just made it too disgusting. This and the Ainz, you could just really control when you want to summon the 3-2 Ainz early and give it all that BS effects. So this was a good hit along with it. And lastly, the other two backups are both powerful cards as well, just very strong defensive backups. So them getting hit was also just nice. Overall, for this, I think you are going to choose the Ainz over these two cards. So essentially, these two cards, in my opinion, are banned.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Pretty much.
So I still think Overlord is powerful. It's just not as crazy and as consistent as it used to be, which I do think is more healthier.
Moving on to Hololive. So I had no idea why this card was banned. I'd never seen it before. But it was this pretty neat build catching on. This 1-0 Ayame. It essentially brings out more of her when she's played on stage. And that can be from hand or from the deck. So essentially what the builds were doing was combining her with this level 0 Madin and level 0 Sora from the first set, where you attack with 3 zeros, two of them being the Madin and the Sora. You attack with them, and then when the Madin attacks, you sack the Sora. The Sora sort of brings out the Ayame from your deck, and you can play the Ayame rested in the back row, and that summons another Ayame, and that summons two more. So you essentially have attack with 3 characters, and then attack with 3 Ayames, and you get 6 attacks at level 1. And this is all easily done because they do have the Roboco, which shuffles 2 characters back into your deck. So it's really easy to get multiple attacks off starting at level 1, which is obviously not good for the game. no deck can possibly keep up with that much damage, I would say. And yeah, they banned it because they didn't want to deal with that shit, which is cool.
Definitely not attended, but it's kind of sick.
It's kind of neat that they came up, that they saw this, you know. This is an old set too. Like the old Hololive set is where the synergy was born. I don't know. It was pretty cool.
It's crazy.
And then the rest of the bans are pretty much targeted at the strong Gouda builds. Gouda Standby is probably the most popular build right now. And a lot of the builds combined it with this Amelia. This Amelia was very strong for building resources for the Gouda to pull off pretty much 3 Goudas and one-shot your opponent, which is the whole point of that deck. You can standby out the Amelias early and start getting more stock very early in the game. So they just wanted to remove that to remove a lot of consistency with the Gouda. And assuming that's also why they banned the Kanata as well. Some people were pairing her with Kanata, but definitely not as popular as the standby version. But still another option that's going to help build stock for the Gouda. The Gouda is a really strong combo, and pulling off multiple does not need to be easy. So I think this will be pretty good. A good ban list. And I think the standby Gouda build should still be able to thrive, just not as consistently and dominating as it has been.
On to Key. This deck is also freaking crazy and really hilarious. They chose these 4 cards because these 4 cards have just very powerful synergy. I mean, the Misuzu combo is so insane. If you get it off, it will one-shot your opponent. The other 3 cards function in a way to make this Misuzu that much more lethal and more consistent. Like, they pretty much mess with your opponent's compression in some shape or form. They either stock swapped or made your opponent reshuffle. And all of the other 3 cards with the Misuzu just kind of made it so the Misuzu is a little too consistent. Like, that Misuzu is just so hilarious, but it's very all in. But when paired up with these other 3 cards, even just any one of those 3 cards or just in tandem together, you can really just mess your opponent's compression and almost making this Misuzu guaranteed. So for example, you can use a stock swap. So all the clean stock is now random. Then you play the Kamane, you choose a climax, and you shuffle all that clean stock back into their deck, and then you blow them up with Misuzu. So much randomness, so much variance, so powerful at pretty light conditions too. So I think this build was super sick, but it wasn't healthy and it had to go. So yeah, all the decompressing shenanigans and messing with your opponent's deck shenanigans are kind of gone in this build. So if you want to run the Misuzu, you got to do it the honest, random way.
And lastly, for what was hit on the ban is D-side once again. The level 3 Landu is now limited to 2. The build was still really strong. I think a lot of people stopped playing it after the first hit, but anyone that the list was still topping. Anyone that was still using it was seeing success with it, and they just decided to hit it again because that the explosiveness of that level 3 Randu at level 2 is something that most decks cannot deal with at all. So it's just really consistent and really strong, and they think it's probably run its course now. So no more D side, I think, after this. This is kind of the nail in the coffin, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
I don't imagine people are going to be playing this set anymore.
He is D side, so
yeah.
Him being at two hurts a lot.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, that does it for what was added to the list. The trend was kind of, you know, trying to stop all the Kuso one-shot builds, like, from just being so consistent and overpowering.
At the very least, make it less consistent.
Yeah.
Like, I think they were intended to be kind of like, oh, fun, like, all in, like, cool, haha, like, I did it. But
yeah,
it was crazy
strong. They were not volatile at all. They're so easy to pull off their game plans.
Mm-hmm.
And SAO, I mean,
SAO is too much. That's
strong at 0, 1, 2, and 3, pretty much. It's like, what are you supposed to do?
It's just too much.
And yeah, moving on to what is unbanned. We'll briefly go over them. The most notable one being like Mushoku Tensei. This is weird, but they got hit with the choice initially. The Rudeus backup and the, what is his name? Ghislaine. I didn't watch this anime, but Ghislaine, 2-2, giving global power, was just really strong. And I think Mushoku suffered a bit because of it, but also mostly because of the environment and the meta it was in. Standby could not really do well right now, unless you had, or Project Sekai, which was great. But so they unbanned it because they want to see more play. And I don't know. I think it will be a lot stronger now. Like, it's going to be one of the top decks again, I feel, with this unban. I mean, they're just free to do everything again. All powerful.
Kind of crazy. They just straight up unban both of them. So
mm-hmm.
I guess it's nice, but it's pretty early. I didn't think this was going to happen.
Yeah, we'll see.
On to a couple other unbans. I mean, they're all pretty nice. Like, Data Live getting unbanned. That's cool. Kaguya-sama getting unbanned. That's cool. And my favorite, of course, Zaycano getting unbanned is really cool. I mean, Little Buster is little choice of two, or limited to two, and the contact collection limited to two. That doesn't really matter. I think the Data Live, Kaguya one, and Zaycano one is more relevant. I think it's a good, I don't think it's going to really bring the decks back to like their former power and like back into the meta, but I think it's a good direction towards it, and maybe Bushi we'll start to maybe unban these sets a little more if these unbans don't really change their state in the meta.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Still waiting on that Sunshine unban, huh?
I'm waiting for y'all, dude. That would be so sick.
But yeah, that's it for what changed on the list. What do we think's going to start happening, huh?
I am honestly surprised they did not hit Puzzles and Dragons with this ban list. Because Puzzles and Dragons is still doing very well, and all of its, you know, competition got hit in some way.
Yeah.
Except Puzzles and Dragons. I understand it's a very new set, and it feels bad whenever you build a brand new set and it gets hit. So yeah, maybe that's why they didn't do it. But still, I think Puzzles and Dragons is going to be very, very powerful right now.
I feel like it'll be the top. It's the only like one shot build that stayed intact after this.
Yes, exactly.
So it's like that thing's gonna be nasty.
Yes, so Puzzle and Dragons will have another couple months to do all the shenanigans.
Mm-hmm.
Besides that, we think Standby will come back more in the meta, perhaps.
Yeah.
Project Sekai is already doing quite well, and so Project Sekai might do even better with this new ban list.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Maybe Quince, you think? Maybe Mushoku Tensei?
I think all standby decks are going to see more play again.
Nijikasaki 8 standby?
Always the sleeper strong OP one.
I want to play that deck again. I couldn't play it against you.
Yeah. I would be crying if I was not an SAO player. But yeah. I was. And I still am crying.
Yeah. maybe more Pixar. I mean, Pixar is doing very well. It didn't ever got hit. So maybe Pixar might do... I mean, Pixar's doing well, so we might even see more Pixar.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And then with the release of Chainsaw Man, I think it'll do well. I mean, if Standby resurges, Chainsaw Man has a lot of tools to beat Standby, so it could thrive in that environment. We'll see.
Well said. And that is it for this video, guys. Once again, if we're forgetting any obvious things or any subtle things, let us know. Or let us know what you think about this ban list in the comments below. Mm-hmm. But with that being said, guys, we'll catch you guys in the next Y Shorts video.
Peace.